In this country alone, there are approximately 1.7 million people living with limb loss. Rates of cancer and trauma-related amputations are decreasing. However, amputations due to complications of the vascular system continue to increase. Ask the Specialist was on location with Dr. Jihad Mustapha at Metro Health Hospital in Grand Rapids, Michigan. Dr. Mustapha has made saving limbs his number one priority.
One of my messages that I really am passionate about and want to get out there is limb salvage. I want every physician that does peripheral vascular disease to focus on that someday. I want them to start paying more attention to saving a limb, even if it takes 2-3 hours of their time, even if they have to do it over and over again. The data supports the fact that you need to keep those limbs on. Now, if it gets to a point that there's nothing you can do, fine. If you, when you get there, you deal with that. But I am sure with today's technology and technical skills that a lot of the physicians out there have, you can save a limb.
Coronary artery disease refers to plaque buildup that causes blockages in arteries of the heart. This same disease can affect all blood vessels, not just the vessels that feed the heart and brain. Blockages in blood vessels of the arms, legs, feet, and organs like the kidneys are referred to as peripheral vascular disease and have the same risk factors.
The diabetes factor has played a major role in increasing the risk of coronary artery disease. And actually, when you're talking about region, West Michigan, specifically an area called Muskegon, has the highest rate of amputation of lower extremities, such as legs. That goes along with a high incidence of coronary artery disease. And actually, it's not just in Michigan. It's spreading everywhere. Cardiovascular disease continues to be on the rise. And it's been related to multiple factors: aging population, sedentary lifestyle, not eating appropriately, lack of exercise, some related to depression. So there's multiple factors. He's been struggling with this for a while, and it's extremely painful to touch. And you can see here he's got an ulcer in his heel.
As plaque builds up in arteries, it reduces and sometimes completely blocks blood flow to vital areas. When blood flow is restricted, limbs and organs die. Advancements in the treatment of coronary and peripheral artery disease make it possible for interventional specialists like Dr. Mustapha to save limbs.
Martha's been struggling with her peripheral vascular disease for a long period of time. When we met her, her foot here was very diseased and she didn't have any flow from this point down, any straight flow. She had total occlusion of her vessels here. So the first time we met her, we spent a long period of time to open one vessel, totally occluded vessel, that allowed nice brisk flow into her foot. I want you to see here, now it's bleeding. That's a good sign. And this was extremely open, not healed ulcer. And this is considering, this is looking good. It's healing here very well, and granulation tissue is looking very good. So now the second stage of the therapy for her, we're going to go back in and open a second vessel. And now she'll have two vessels run off to the foot, which will allow us to provide for her complete blood flow, and this will continue to heal. Martha's come a long way, and she's done a great job. She's healed really well. And these are the kind of cases that makes it worthwhile. So we'll let you get ready again, and we'll schedule you for the next procedure really soon. And we'll continue to make you feel better. It was nice to see you again. I'd like to see you smiling. I am taking it upon myself as a personal agenda to one day eliminate or at least reduce the amputation by 50% or more in this country. Why? Because these poor patients that lose their legs, you know, imagine what's going to happen next. They're going to die. It depends on the age. You know, if you're 60, 70 years old and you lose your leg, you're going to become basically bedbound.
Dr. Mustapha, as an interventional cardiologist, is trained in the technique of non-invasive catheterization as a way to treat peripheral vascular disease. This method of treatment makes it possible to clear even 100% blocked vessels under light sedation for immediate results. Using a device that can best be described as a roto-rooter for the arteries, the Diamondback catheter chips away rock-hard calcifications to achieve blood flow.
So you can see here that there's significant blockage. Look at this heavily, heavily calcified lesion right here. So we're gonna go after this and fix it. Can I get the Diamondback, please, guys? This is where the total occlusion is. So now we're gonna go ahead and get ready and bring our specialized wire for the crosser. Sweet. Oh man, that's beautiful. So really beautiful, beautiful results. So remember, this foot here did not have any blood flow to it before this procedure. So let me show you what we got now and why this is so rewarding to do. So we got both vessels opened, the upper lobe and the lower lobe.
Spending time with Dr. Mustapha at Metro Health Hospital, you get the sense of how many lives he has changed.
We have 32 patients that were scheduled for amputation. They were set to go for amputations. They came to us as a second opinion. We've saved every leg. So he's not going to have any compromise of blood flow to his feet at all. Got good pulses. Now remember, you promised us on camera yesterday, we have it, that you're going to exercise.
You got that on camera?
Oh, yeah. All right. And we'll get back and
we'll do her.
Hand you down someday.
We'll do her.
You have a good day, buddy.
I trust you.
I appreciate it.
And so does my family.
That means a lot to me. That means the world to me. I appreciate it. Yeah.
For more information about Dr. Mustapha and the Metro Health Limb Salvage Clinic in Grand Rapids, Michigan, please log on to askthespecialist.tv.